famous, what they call me. I promise that you.
Hello, guys. Yes, yes, yes. Today is Taco Tuesday. Yes, it is Taco Tuesday, man. I know y'all miss me Friday, you know, but I was feeling really sick, and I really wasn't feeling good, so I couldn't really do anything. But I'm back, guys. Whew. So it has been a lot going on. A lot. I had my other tacos over here on the side. I just don't want it all up in the video. So there has been two mass shootings. Now I know I told y'all about the one in Ohio at that garlic festival. And there also was another one in Texas. And it was a mall shooting. They actually have a Walmart in the mall, which is really nice. And there was a shooting, and he killed like 22 people. Now they said, I'm the taco queen. I love tacos. Yo, they said that he was targeting Hispanic Americans. But the thing about white supremacists is they don't like anybody. They don't even like their own kind. That's what makes them so dangerous. They can't be trusted. Ever. Then on top of that, they kill kids, they don't care. You think they would have a little compassion. They don't. I mean, why would they? But they said they went in his house. And they found letters up him and stuff saying that he was doing threats and stuff, saying that he was going to do this, do that. It's like these terrorists and stuff. White supremacist group. They winning. Mm-hmm.
But I think we should it's too many people being killed now. During these mass shootings, so we gotta come up with a way to do something to stop it. Now, a lot of people cry. To having people, more people armed, ain't gonna help. But I think it would help. They're gonna go both ways. Because depending on what kind of gun he has, if he got like a one of them guns that hold a lot of magazines, like a Uzi or something like that, it's gonna take time to even try to hit him, not unless you got a sniper. Because you got a duck, because he's doing all, he's shooting all these rounds off. And you're not trying to get hit. You gotta wait for the perfect time. Yeah, I was watching the Trey King show. I love the show. I'm gonna be doing shout outs. I'm definitely gonna be doing shout outs Friday because I know I missed it. But I'm trying to get a lot of people that I can shout out. I'm trying to get a list. Well, that's why I wanted to hold off. So it's Friday. I was looking at this show, he was doing a story on. This lady that worked at Arby's and the customer spit on her. And she killed him. When she got outside, so she was justified. Because she had came back to the job. I was talking about people wait for her to start her and stuff. But what she should have did, she should have called the cop. Like she fouled him. She should have never did that. overtime rule is justified. I don't know how many times I had to tell people. And this is a disclaimer, because I'm not telling anybody to go use this information for bad and just go shoot my PDF right now. But I'm telling you guys that if you're in a situation and you feel that you're going to be harmed, or you feel that somebody's trying to take your life, you better do some kind of warning shot. If you have a gun. Because if not, that's just cold-blooded murder. It's the same situation. If you gave him a warning shot, that dude will probably die there. You always gonna get slapped for that. I got my sunglasses on because I got a skylight. I don't know, sometimes my eyes are sensitive to light. Got one of my sunglasses. But that's good. I remember recording how she probably felt. I ain't never been spit on before. But I know that's nasty. I don't care how mad you're at somebody. You should never spit on nobody. You know? Excuse me. You should never spit on nobody, ever. I don't care. I don't know what they were arguing about. Maybe his order wasn't right. Maybe she got smart with him. Or maybe he wanted his money back and she said no. I don't know what the situation was. But all I know is that in the situation, a young man was dead. Said he drove to a Walmart and his truck crashed, and that's where he died. Approach. She shot him in the chest. But I believe she's gonna get some time because she didn't give him no warning. Fuel gave a warning shot. It would have been different. And on top of that, she didn't have no permit to have that gun. So that's a big strike against her. For real. These tacos are banging. I got all nacho cheese supreme. I went down around about three something. I don't like going like around 12 because people go on their lunch break, it be packed. We got a lot of restaurants around this Taco Bell. And you got a car shop over here with Taco Bell. I got a place where you can bowl. Oh, and then I got the post office. Let me see how many I eat. So them post office people, one. Yeah. Okay, I ate five so far. Yeah, so the post office people and all the other people, they probably, you know, when they go on break, they probably go over to Taco Bell and get lunch. But some of these situations that I be hearing about, they're terrible. And I have a mass shooting like that, back to back. That's crazy, but I want to see what's going to happen with the lady with this Arby situation. Because I understand how that can make her mad. You know, getting spit on. And that might not have been no little spit. You know, some of them people do one of them big hog spits. Hog spits, they call them. You know what I'm saying? Get your right in the eye. But man, that's just a crazy situation. People don't think. She should have thought about it, but I'm like, do I really want to spend a whole lot of years in jail for killing this man? Or do y'all want my freedom? Look at that sour cream. Mm. But we as people ourselves, we gotta do better. We gotta start to learn to control our anger, even when it's bad. Cause I know that half of y'all, if somebody spit at y'all, y'all probably, a lot of you guys wouldn't kill them, but you would want to be fighting. Sometimes we gotta learn to control our anger. But sometimes that's a hard situation because the cop's really not going to do nothing with somebody spitting on it. I mean, it is assault, but most police are going to think it's a waste of their time to come down there and somebody spit on you. Like, I never know anybody to get locked up for spitting on somebody. I haven't. Excuse me, so the thing is do we take it in our own hands and settle it? Like just slap that person? Or beat them up real bad and then the cops be called and then you go to jail because of assault? You know, you got different kinds of assault. You got deadly assault and you got simple assault. And spitting on somebody, that's simple, so they're not going to get a lot of time for that. But if you pull out a knife, you done change the whole situation. You done change the whole situation.